Another useful feature in the values is we have the ability to see what makes up any one of these numbers. What you may realize is, let's say you decide that this number over here looks a little bit too low. It's a little bit difficult to figure out what makes up that number. You'd kind of have to go into the phone bill and do it all manually. But what you can do with any value cell is, if you double click, what it does, it creates a new sheet. And it extracts the database of all the information that made up that cell. So if we add up this bill column, you'll see it comes to 184, which is the number there. If, for example, I want more information on that one, I double click it, you'll notice it's a new sheet. And in this case, only two lines make up that information. And you see you can check it, but it'll always add up to the correct number. So doing that, you have the ability to analyze what's happening. But just keep in mind that these two extracts are just that, they are extracts. If, for example, you discover that there's a problem here and you want to change it, you cannot change it here. This does not feed into the pivot table. You will need to go back here and actually make the correction if there's something to be corrected. Another useful aspect of this is that if, for example, you've got some other work to do, or perhaps you don't have access to the data, a quick way to get back to the raw information is to come here, and at the grand total level, if we double click that one, notice that that's going to pull through March's details. And if we switch the grand totals on, what I could do is double click the grand total, and this now, you'll notice 934 rows. If we go to our original source, you'll see it's 935 rows, just because we've got that one extra there. So by double clicking any of these numbers, you have access to what makes up the number, and it can be useful just to almost recreate the underlying database.